You may know the next two presenters as Moto Crab and Xeno Crab on the Hermit Crab Association. Samantha has been keeping hermit crabs for approximately 16 years. Shortly after meeting Dan in 2016, they both began researching hermit crabs online and found the Hermit Crab Association. Dan and Samantha began to change up Samantha's 20-gallon tall to proper specifications. They instantly noticed an increase in activity and growing crabs. With each new tank, their decor was becoming more and more complex. After posting pictures online, several crabbers showed an interest in their creations. So in the spring of 2020, Dan and Samantha opened Cenobita Curiosities on Etsy. They offer many of the items they use in their own crabitats. Today, Dan and Samantha are the proud owners of 35 to 40 hermit crabs living in 5 different crabitats. Their colony includes 6 captive bred babies, 5 strawberries, 4 Ecuadorians, and countless rescued and adopted purple pinchers. They both credit their success with hermit crabs to the Hermit Crab Association and Land Hermit Crab Owners Society for their valuable care guides. When Dan and Samantha aren't busy taking care of their hermit crabs, they enjoy going to heavy metal concerts and amusement parks. They also love volunteering at a local haunted house that benefits local volunteer fire departments. They practice a strict plant-based lifestyle, although their hermit crabs do not. Please welcome Dan and Samantha.
When we started keeping hermit crabs, we had 3 in a 10-gallon. Now we have around 40 hermit crabs in 5 different crabitats. Keeping up with their voracious appetites was getting to be expensive. A small pack of food would only last us a few weeks. Every other month, we were spending $30 or more on foods. This presentation is based on our experiences over the last year with finding ways to get more for less when it comes to feeding our crabs. As an added bonus, you can eat everything here too. We always see a lot of questions from new crabbers about what can be fed safely. We are going to cover easy to find fruits and veggies at grocery stores. We will also cover finding flowers and other plants in bulk from health food stores. Once we go over the foods, we will show you how we dehydrate our crabby foods. We are going to keep it simple and cover the basics to get you started. Keep in mind, you can experiment and try different techniques.
We tried to make the information universal based on the care guides and safe food lists from the Hermit Crab Association, Land Hermit Crab Owners Society, and the Crab Street Journal. We decided to only use organic items for this presentation. No group states that all foods offered to hermit crabs must be organic. Each group agrees that foods and items foraged should be harvested from pesticide-free areas. The Land Hermit Crab Owners Society clearly states in their foraging list, and I quote, "It is important to remember all items collected for your hermit crabs must be free of pesticides and chemicals," end quote. The Hermit Crab Association also warns in their care guide, Hermit Crab Nutrition by Kilimanjaro, about pesticides. And I quote, "Food warning number 4, pesticides in foods. Most of the fruits and vegetables we eat today have been sprayed with pesticides in order to produce more food to feed the growing population, because pesticides and insecticides are designed to target the exoskeletons of insects. It is possible that pesticides can be harmful to hermit crabs because they also have an exoskeleton. Many crabbers opt to buy natural and organic products in order to cut out pesticide consumption. Berries and thin-skinned foods have the highest amount of pesticides in them, and many crabbers make sure to buy these organic. Foods with thick peels or rinds absorb most of the pesticides in the skin, and the skin should not be fed unless it is organic, end quote.
With both groups offering these statements, they promote using the safest foods as possible for our pinchy shell-wearing friends. We highly suggest everyone do their own research and make your own choices based on your own research. A Google search of chemical pesticides in agriculture should be enough to get started. We highly suggest looking into the EWG, the Environmental Working Group's Clean 15 and Dirty Dozen lists. These lists contain the least and most pesticides in common produce. Due to the high content of pesticides found in the Dirty Dozen, we believe purchasing these items organic are the safest for you and your crabs. Another big question people have is between organic and natural. Organic farming has a lot of rules and regulations, making sure the products are what they are. Natural is a generic term that has no regulations. Here is a graph that shows the types of regulations in organic farming compared to natural.
Due to COVID-19 and the current restrictions in our area, we decided to not take pictures in the grocery store. We will go over all the items we purchased in the next few slides. Now that all the disclaimers and technical stuff is out of the way, let's go grocery shopping. Our first stop was at Aldi's. Don't forget your quarter for the shopping cart. They offer organic produce, fresh and frozen. Let's go over what we found. The organic cashews and almonds probably weren't the most cost-effective purchase on this list. These are raw and unsalted. They have a slightly different flavor compared to what you are used to. The organic butternut squash we found in the frozen section. The same with the organic sweet potatoes. Organic sweet peas. And organic corn. All the frozen items can be thawed and offered as is. Organic bananas. Organic strawberries. Organic blackberries. Organic blueberries. And organic gala apples.
We often eat the apples and offer our crabs the cores. Here are two of our crabs munching on an apple core. If the picture looks familiar, it won the calendar crab contest from March 2020. Always be sure to remove the cores before the crabs get to the seeds. The seeds contain trace amounts of arsenic. We also picked up organic creamy peanut butter. This peanut butter contains sea salt. Sea salt is made from the evaporation of salt water. The various colors are due to the trace minerals in the water. With sea salt being naturally occurring, it is considered safe for hermit crabs. Standard salt is mined, processed, and often contains anti-caking agents. While it is unproven that iodine is harmful, the anti-caking agents are what makes standard salt harmful to our hermit crabs. The good thing, unlike worm castings, you can eat all these foods yourself and share with your crabs. Let's break down our purchases from this shopping trip. Cashews, $7.99. Almonds, $8.99. Butternut squash and sweet potatoes were $1.85 each. Sweet peas and sweet corn, $1.99 each. Almost 1.5 pounds of bananas were 63 cents. Peanut butter, $3.45. Strawberries, $3.49. Blackberries, $3.29. Blueberries, $2.29. Gala apples, $3.89. The total was $41.60.
Next up, we went to Bloom Naturally, a local health food store. They weren't very busy, so we asked permission to take photos inside their store. We explained that we were working on a hermit crab food presentation, and we're using the photos for that. They thought that was the coolest thing. They offer a wide variety of organic bulk products like seeds, beans, nuts, and the hermit crab favorite, popcorn. Prices are listed in pounds, so you pay by the actual weight of the product. Our favorite area is the dried flower and plant section. This is where it is a good idea to have your safe food list of choice handy to use as a reference. There are a lot of choices, but some may not be safe for your hermit crabs. If you aren't sure, don't purchase it.
Here are the items we purchased specifically for this presentation. We placed a large order a few weeks before we decided to do this. We used a clear measuring cup to try to show how much we actually got for the price. Jasmine flowers, $1.53 for 2/3 cup. Red clover blossom, 89 cents for half a cup. Rose hips, $1.74 for 1/3 cup. Rose buds and pink petals, $1.91 for half a cup. Calendula flowers, 60 cents for half a cup. Hibiscus flowers, $1.14 for half a cup. Cut dandelion leaf, 67 cents for a quarter cup. And German chamomile, 81 cents for a quarter cup. This store sells these in paper bags. To keep these fresher longer, we purchased a bunch of small storage containers with tight-fitting lids. We keep reusing these over and over. All of this food was under $10 and will easily feed 3 to 5 crabs for several months. We only touched on a very small portion of easy-to-find items in grocery stores. Be sure to print out a safe food list and keep it in the car or save to your phone. If you're like us, every grocery shopping trip turns into a, I wonder if our crabs would like this or can they eat that? You will be amazed at how many foods you can share with your crabs. Here are a few of our crabs as we move into our next segment.
Now that we just purchased a lot of fresh fruits and veggies for our crabs, what will we do with them before they go bad? We can eat everything ourselves, but our poor crabbies will not have any tasty foods. We can also try to freeze everything, but our freezer is probably full.
Dehydrators can usually be found on Craigslist, OfferUp, Letgo, and Facebook Marketplace on the cheap. People plan to dehydrate everything and only use it a few times, then let it take up space in a closet, eventually selling it for a fraction of the price. We found our Nesco American Harvester on Craigslist 2 years ago for $40. It came with additional trays and plastic liners. It even came with the original instructions. Before our Nesco, we bought a small $20 or $30 new one. That one only lasted 2 or 3 uses. The plastic tray is either warped or cracked due to the heat. If you purchase a dehydrator, new or used, try to do a little research to find a few reviews. That way you have a pretty good idea of what you are getting. First up is a given, a dehydrator. I have read about people using their oven to dehydrate, but I can't give any advice on that. Parchment paper. Pre-cut the paper to all your trays. Cutting board and knives to slice and dice all the produce. Some type of way to puree. Magic bullet, coffee grinder, food processor. Organic coconut oil. We spread the coconut oil on all the parchment paper before we start the produce prep work. Even though the paper is non-stick, foods high in natural sugars like bananas tend to stick on uncoated paper. It's no fun when the foods stick to the paper. Crabs love coconut, so adding a little coconut flavor is an added bonus. Our first fruit will be the apples we bought at Aldi. We cored, then cubed them. We tossed them into our food processor and turned them into applesauce. We then poured the sauce onto the tray, spreading it evenly. We peeled and broke up the banana into bite-sized pieces and put them in the bullet. We blended the bananas until it was a thick liquid, similar to a pancake batter. We evenly poured this onto the next tray. The butternut squash we thawed and mashed with a potato masher. It doesn't have to be perfectly mashed, just broken down so it can be spread thin so it dries evenly. Blueberries are the next victims of the bullet. These were blended into a thick paste. Here you can see the butternut squash and blueberries on the same tray. The blackberries were condemned to the same fate as the blueberries. Same process as before. By now I'm sure you are seeing a pattern here.
We decided to slice up a few strawberries to fill the other half of this tray. A lot of what we are dehydrating can be dehydrated many different ways. Apples and bananas can be sliced thin. Berries can be pinched to break the skin, then dehydrated. Crabs like things in different ways, so experimenting with different techniques is always good to see what they enjoy the most. Here are the strawberries being blended, same as before, then poured into the tray. We also thawed the sweet peas and sweet corn and spread them out on one tray. We forgot to take a picture of this, so here's Krusty and Fleabag having some fun at the park instead. Now that everything is prepped, we turned on the dehydrator to 135 degrees Fahrenheit for about 22 hours. Let the time lapse and music begin. This is Eddie R. Ecuadorian. We lost him last year in a bacterial bloom. We still miss him greatly, and this presentation is dedicated to him.
Here are the apples dehydrated. They will easily break into smaller chunks. We ran them through the bullet to turn them into a powder. A coffee grinder will work too. When using a coffee grinder, you will need to use smaller portions, otherwise the powder will get stuck under the blades. Using 5 apples, we managed to get 3/8 of a cup of powder. Bananas always brown a lot more than other fruits we've tried. They also tend to be rubbery, similar to a thick fruit roll-up. We break these up into little chunks and process them the same way as the apples. We used 3 bananas and it gave us 1/2 cup of powder. If you purchased our Curiosity Cubes from Cinobita Curiosities, this is the technique we use for our banana popcorn. The butternut squash really thins out after dehydrating. Once powdered, we only got about 1/4 cup. Blueberries are the same way. They gave us about 1/4 cup of powder. Blackberries are also similar when dehydrated. Once again, we got about 1/4 cup of powder. The strawberries are always a bright color when dried. An entire package of strawberries gives us over 1/4 cup of powder. The sweet peas and sweet corn were about 1/2 cup of each frozen bag. The sweet peas, once powdered, gave us about 1/4 cup. The sweet corn, powdered, also gave us about 1/4 cup. As you can see, you will get quite a bit of dehydrated foods and super happy crabbies.
This concludes our presentation. We hope we helped explain things to consider when purchasing foods and where to begin shopping. We only briefly touched on everything. Ultimately, anything offered to your hermit crabs is your decision. You should always do your research and ask questions within the hermit crab community from trusted moderators. Thank you for watching. Let the credits roll.